Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our daily current affair MCQs based series. So as is clear from its name, so this series is about your daily current affair MCQs. So today is 27 August, so we will here discuss the MCQs of today. So what we do in this series, we discuss daily your 10 MCQs based on the current affairs. So let's start for the today's current affairs. The first question is, consider the following statements related to World Skills Competition. First, it is an event organized by International Labor Organization. Second, World Skills India is an initiative under the Ministry of Labor to participate in this competition. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are incorrect, because it is not organized by ILO, but it is organized by World Skills International. So World Skills India is an initiative under this Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. So the answer would be D, neither one nor two. So World Skills World Skills International organized every 2 years, biggest vocational education and skills excellence event in the world. So it aims to the competition include demonstrating the advantages of learning a vocational skill and encouraging a parity of esteem between vocational and academic qualifications. So about World Skills, it has currently 79 member countries, and most of which organize national skills competitions that help prepare the workforce and talent of today for the jobs of the future. So it was formerly known as International Vocation Training Organization. It was founded in 1940s. So what is World Skills India? World Skills India is basically an initiative of National Skill Development Corporation under the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. NSDC through its World Skills India initiative has been leading the country's participation at World Skills International competition since 2011. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to Regional Comprehensive Partnership Agreement. The abbreviation is wrong. It is not Regional Comprehensive Partnership Agreement, it is Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. So we have to consider the following statements for it. First, it is a proposed agreement between the SAARC countries. Second, it aims to boost trade by eliminating most tariff and non-tariff barriers. So which of the above statements is correct? So let me tell you friends that the first statement is correct. It is not an agreement between SAARC countries, but actually it is an agreement between ASEAN countries and 6 other countries with which ASEAN grouping has free trade agreement. So first is wrong, second is correct. So it aims to boost the trade by eliminating the most tariff and non-tariff based barriers. So the answer would be B, that is second only. So solution is B. So RCEP is basically the agreement between ASEAN and 6 other nations with which ASEAN has a free trade agreement, that is Australia, China, India, Japan, South Korea and New Zealand. So it was formally launched in November 2012 and aim is to boost goods trade by eliminating most tariff and non-tariff barriers. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, gravitational lensing seen in news recently will be significant for the reason. A, to understand dark matter. B, to discover new minds. C, to understand gravitational anomaly. D, none of the above. So friends, let me tell you that the answer is to understand dark matter. So basically this gravitational lensing is understanding about how the stars are born, and so it also focuses upon the dark matter due to this reason. So this is in detail explanation of it, so you can see it in the PDF itself. So let's move on to the next question. Next is special data dissemination standards is related to. A, Asian Development Bank. B, World Trade Organization. C, International Monetary Fund. D, World Bank. So let me tell you friends that the answer is World Bank, that is D, World Bank. So it is basically the special data IMF, not World Bank. So it is basically it was in news yesterday because a report was released in which IMF said that India has been faring poorly on these standards because most of the data is delayed and is not updated. So annual observance report of special data dissemination standard for 2018, India failed to comply with multiple requirements prescribed in the data special data dissemination standard. So basically it is a global benchmark for disseminating macroeconomic statistics to the public. So this basically is a kind of standard which ensures that the countries must know that what standards must be followed in context of data coverage, periodicity, timelines of data, public access, data integrity and data quality. Let's move on to the next question. Next is Project Insight is in news recently related to. So it was in news recently. So it is related to A, income tax. It is related to income tax. B, space project. C, biotechnology project. D, none of the above. So friends, let me tell you, this is related to income tax. So Project Insight is basically to improve the tax compliance by using the data that is being generated through use of information technology in tax related matters. So it ensures that tax compliance can be improved, and it is used to check that whether the persons who are liable to pay the tax are paying it properly or not. And your next question is, consider the following statements related to Project Sure. First, it is the initiative of Ministry of Textiles to promote sustainable development products. Second, it gives tax exemption to environment friendly products. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you friends that your both of the statements are incorrect. So it is not an initiative of Ministry of Textiles, and there is no such thing that is tax exemption is given to environmental friendly products. So answer is neither 1 and 2. So it is a voluntary commitment by India's textile industry, apparel industry, to set a sustainable pathway for the Indian fashion industry. So SURE stands for Sustainable Resolution. So it is a firm commitment from the industry to move towards fashion that contributes to a clean environment. So it would help the industry reduce its carbon emission, increase resource efficiency, tackle waste and water management, and create positive social impact to achieve long-term sustainability targets. And let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements related to president's rule in India. First, when the president's rule is imposed in a state, the legislative assembly will dissolve automatically. Second, under the president's rule, the high court also comes under the jurisdiction of the central government. So we have to choose which of the above statement is correct. So let me tell you friends that both of these statements are not correct. The answer is neither 1 nor 2. So High Court doesn't come under the jurisdiction of central government, and when president rule is imposed, it is not that the legislative assembly is automatically dissolved. So it has to be dissolved by the governor. So answer is D, neither 1 nor 2. So reference, you can see the Lakshmikant book. Next question is, Justice B.N. Shri Krishna Committee is in news recently is related to A, Uniform Civil Code, B, Data Protection Law, C, Subcategorization of OBC, D, none of the above. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. So B.N. Shri Krishna Committee is basically, it was seen in news because it proposed draft Data Protection Law. So draft data protection law, this committee was basically set up to ensure that how the privacy of the citizens can be ensured by protecting their data. So it made comprehensive recommendations including a draft law for data protection. So draft takes into account three aspects of the data, that is citizen, state and industry, and it notes that the privacy is fundamental right, and here the critical personal data of Indian citizens, it says that it must be processed in centers located within country, and it aims to protect your personal data from informational as an essential facet of informational privacy, and also it tries to ensure that data processors do not misuse your data. So these are in detail recommendations of it, so you can see it. Next, move on to the next question, ninth question. Consider the following statements related to biotechnology. First, molecular seizures of bacteria is a self-defense system that protects bacteria from viral infection. Second, viruses need host cells to replicate themselves using the host DNA molecules. So which of the above statements is correct? Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are correct. Answer is C, that is both 1 and 2. So basically, the group of scientists from Indian Institute of Science Education and Research, Pune, claim to have determined the atomic structure of complex bacterial protein MCRBC, which helps to prevent viral infections in bacterial cell and functions as a molecular sieve. So atomic structure also helps in understanding the working of molecular sieves, and high resolution structure of MCRBC was possible by using this electron cryomicroscopy, commonly known as cryo-EM. So then there is phage therapy. So you can read about these things if these are important. So you can read these things in your PDF. And your last question of the day is WTO came into existence under which treaty? A. Marrakesh Treaty, B. Bretton Woods Conference, C. Maastricht Treaty, and D. None of the above. So friends, let me tell you, the answer is Marrakesh Agreement. So WTO basically came into existence after Marrakesh Agreement. So your Bretton Woods Conference resulted in the GATT, which was, that is General Agreement on Tariffs and Trade. So which was then later changed to WTO and the Marrakesh Agreement, and the mandate of this GATT transferred to WTO. So it is an important international body regulating the trade, international trade in the global community. So this is all about friends today's questions. If you like the questions, if you like the MCQs, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends. And also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And if in case you want the PDF of these MCQs, then you can contact us at achieveias21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at 8968920720. So also we will be providing you the link of the subscription in the description box. So obviously we have kept a minimum fee for the subscription, that is rupees 99 per month. So this has been kept to ensure that this MCQ series remain affordable to you people, as well as it helps us in motivating ourselves to help you people. So if in case you are interested, then you can mail us or you can contact us on the given number, or you can also check the description box for the link of subscription. So friends, lastly, we have also a Telegram channel on which you can join, and here we post our regular updates about the initiatives that we have taken for the purpose of your UPSC CSE. And you can also visit our website, that is www.achieveias.co.in, on which we upload articles daily that are of relevance from your current point of view. So this is all about today's video. Do ensure that you like it and share it. Thank you friends. Have a very nice day ahead.